Life is like a train. Say, your speech is very beautiful. And just let me to remember about a quote in the Bible. It says, ask and it will be given to you. Seek and you will find. I believe in Sally's speech, by her experience that she shared about each station in her life. Like to find a church accidentally, and to join a small group, and also got baptized in a church. You know, and the last is her mom started to read Bible, and I think all the stories that Sally shared to us is very, very precious, because that is her journey in his spiritual life. And I really like it, because that is not easy. It's not like share how to cook or how to study. It's about her spiritual life. I think that is not easy job. But Sally's used a very beautiful word to let us know her journey. And just like he started to find, and also he felt the love from God, I think that is the journey, the purpose of his speech, of her speech. But since her speech purpose is about body language, I would suggest that if you can use more body language in some of the experience, like you walk on the Huntington Road and you walk up and there's a breath of life. Then she said, what is breath of life? Let me walk into you to find out. Maybe you can just to choose some of the moments and you can share your emotion. Like we got baptized. Maybe you can share more about the experience, why you want to get baptized, because this is very a very important moment in life. And I would like to suggest that maybe you can summarize one to two experiences, because your speech is full of each station and the content is very beautiful, but the audience would like to get focused to one to two stories. Maybe the audience can know about the feeling and the journey that you want to share. Yep. And for you all, I think the journey, life is like a train, is very beautiful. And everyone is on a train, but everyone can choose to stay or to keep on moving. Thank you.